Hello, hello.
Hello.
It's so good that folks can hear. Can hear me.
Am I the only person that decided to?
I know. That's great. Well, I have my water here. Yeah. I'll have some wine afterwards. Yeah.
It's a little sweet. Mm-hmm. You mix it up and then you top it off with sparkling wine. And I think I let.
Yes. That is
put in enough sparkling wine.
Right.
But there's no more room in the glass. Right. So it's a little sweet.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to pull up the questions, which I have here, but I have to pull them up.
Okay. And folks are wonderfully joining, which is fantastic. I'm seeing some familiar faces, so that's even more fantastic. All right. Okay. Oh, someone's in the waiting room, so let's admit them. Perfect. Awesome. Okay, so it's 6:31. Let's go ahead and get started. So as folks are on, well, standing in and joining, we'll go ahead and we can fill folks in. So welcome, everyone. Thank you so much for taking this time to come and meet the Artomatic board. It's been a while, well, it's been really a year since we've seen you all. Although the board members, we see each other monthly, but let's go ahead and get started. So, okay, let's see. Catherine, real quick, just a quick admin. Are you able to admit folks in the waiting room or shall I go ahead and do that?
If you can do it, I think there's a way to make me the administrator. I haven't done it in a while. I've admitted people to meetings I started. I'm not sure how you switch the administrator. I've done it, but it's been a while.
Okay. Not a problem. I can, I'll go ahead and do that as I see them coming in. Okay. Are you all able to see folks in the waiting room?
Not me.
Okay. All right. Okay. Sounds good. So I'll go ahead and get started. My name is Jamila Canty. I am currently serving as the Artomatic Board President. And I am honored that you all are here. I want to thank our board for coming up with this fantastic idea to have a wonderful happy hour meet and greet with the board. I think it's well-deserved and well-needed. I am going to let the board introduce themselves, but before I do, if the board members can, of course, introduce yourself, discuss the type of art that you create, what is your art genre, and how long you've been with Artomatic, how many Artomatics you've been a part of, as well as how long you've been on the board. So I'll go. I create mixed media art on canvas and wood. My first Artomatic that I've ever been to was in 2007 in Crystal City, and I fell in love with Artomatic. It was like so wonderful, and I just wanted to definitely be a part of it. From there, I participated in, of course, as we all know, as folks who are Artomatics, we volunteer, and I wanted to do more and be more of a part of Artomatic. So I was able to join the board, first as the secretary, and then transition to co-president and now president. So from there, I'm going to call out the board members that I am seeing. And if you can introduce yourself, that will be wonderful. And then we can get to the wonderful questions that you all have. So Catherine, I see you on my screen first. So you go ahead and go.
Hi, my name is Catherine Azelford. And the kind of art that I usually make is theater. But I really like visual art. My mom was a painter and I grew up around paintings and galleries. The first Artomatic I went to was, I think, 2000. It was the one in what was the old Heckinger's on Wisconsin Avenue, and I loved it. And I participated in a couple of Artomatics with staged readings and theater performances since then. And I joined the board, I believe, about a year and a half ago.
Yeah. And we're glad to have you aboard.
So nice.
Nancy, you're next up. You're muted if you're.
Hi, I'm Nancy Abelis. I've been a board member. Currently, I'm an advisor. And Catherine, you jogged my memory because actually the first Artomatic I ever went to was the one in the Heffingers in 2000 also. And it was like Disneyland of art. I fell in love with it. Oh, wait, hold on a second. Hello? You're gonna have to call me the show. I'm in the middle of my Zoom. Bye. Sorry. Okay. So I became active in 2008. I started showing and I got involved with kids' activities, and I was co-chair of that, and I was active in 2009 to 2016, where I worked on the communications committee. And I just love the camaraderie as well as the chance to experience all of the wonderful art and performance and fun.
Fantastic. All right. Shanti, you're muted. Let me see if I can unmute folks.
Hello, everyone. Good evening. My name is Shanti Chandrasekhar. I'm a multimedia artist and I play around with mediums. Whatever interests me, I use art as my medium to understand it, whether it's science, music, or art, or anything else. So I joined the board, the Artomatic board, about a year ago, and I've been an advisor. And I was introduced to Artomatic in 2007 when I joined for the first time, and I have participated in about five, and my daughter has participated, my students have participated, so it's been like an event that we've all been participating in.
Awesome. Yep. Okay. Chris, looking very dapper this evening.
I just got in from work. So I'm Chris Brownlow. I joined the board right after the last Artomatic in 2017 in Crystal City, which was also my first. I'm not an artist. I'm just here for the fun. I've been on the board since late 2017.
Awesome. Okay, I see Nico. Well, I hear Nico. Can you unmute Nico?
I'm sorry, I'm just not good with this stuff. I'm recent to Artomatic. I can't remember. It was the first event. It was the more recent event. I think the last event for Artomatic. Just my memory is not really good right now. I've never participated as an artist. I do multiple things, I guess, sculpture, fashion, crafts, just wanting to actually find my voice at this point in my life. And I thought being around like-minded people,
yes,
would help me do that. Trying to get out, you know, get out of this box I put myself in, really. So when I first experienced Artomatic and I saw so many different things in one space, so many creative people just, you know, putting themselves out there, and it was just beautiful. I mean, it bring, you know, I have chills right now, and just wanting to be a part of that experience. I'm just ready to be a part of it.
Hi.
Hello. So right now we're introducing our board members and advisors. So let's see. I see Kate.
Hi, everybody. My name is Kate Sinclair. I am a recent board member. I feel like I haven't really had an opportunity to participate just yet as an artist, and also with you all. So I'm always happy for these opportunities to talk with you. I part-time teach ceramics at Capitol Hill Arts Workshop. I also hold workshops, painting workshops. The most recent was through CHAW, Capitol Hill Arts Workshop, partnering with Armed Services Arts Partnership. So it was a painting workshop for veterans. And I designed the class to talk about inspiration. And so I'm really focused on sharing the tools to see like an artist for other people to promote personal development and ways of seeing the world in a positive light. So good for everybody, good life skills to have. And I came to Artomatic through George. I met him on a cold approach through, where was it, George? LinkedIn. It was through LinkedIn. So George and I were communicating through LinkedIn, and I was a new person to DC. And so we reached out to have coffee, and here I am today. So it was a great opportunity to meet him during the uncertainty of the pandemic. It was like, what is happening in the DC art scene? And it was a great little shining star through that time. I'm just really eager to get more integrated with you guys and know everybody. And my own personal artwork is, recently I've been doing oil pastels. I really love going out to mostly near places of water, going on walks in nature, to rivers, to streams, and just doing en plein air oil pastels. I think it's extremely, extremely satisfying. So, yeah.
Fantastic. And last but not least, I specifically did this because we have George here, who is the founder and the brainchild of Artomatic. So George, take it away. Right. Yes, definitely. Round of applause.
You know, you might want to call Angie. She's on, I think she's not just on Void, and have her introduce herself.
Yes, I'm sorry. Angie, I am so sorry. Hold on, let me... Okay. Yep, I see. Sorry about that, Angie. Yeah.
That's okay. Can you guys hear me? I think I'm off mute. Yeah. So I'm also kind of new to the board. I an advisor as of about a little over a year ago. And my first Artomatic was in 2012. And I just really loved being a part of it. And so then when I was back in the area then in 2020 for the virtual Artomatic, I participated in that one too. So I do a lot of kind of small fantastical pieces and also writing. So yeah, it's just been great to be a part of it.
Awesome. Okay. Are there any more board members or advisors on that I may not be seeing on my screen?
A minute. If I could just take a second.
Yes, definitely. Yeah. I was doing that before I introduced you. Yeah, what I was doing that for.
My name is George Cook. I'm fortunate in that I was associated with a group of six artists that founded, really by accident, the first Artomatic in 1999. And I'm a painter. Originally in school, I was a ceramic major. Like most of you, building community and being able to build our own network is so important, particularly for individual artists who are usually doing their work in solitude. And like many of the board members and advisors, and I'm serving as an advisor now. It's a real joy to connect with people and exchange ideas and collaborate together. Thank you.
Awesome. Okay. So we do have a few. So right now we're going to transition into what we have been up to as a board, and then we'll transition into the question that you all may have. But it looks like one of our board members is joining right now, Tracy, who is our secretary. So let's give her a little bit of time before she introduces rather than putting her immediately on the spot because she literally just joined. We'll go into what we've been doing lately as a board since our the last time we've seen you all. So as you all know, we had our 20th anniversary, the virtual Artomatic in 2020, that's been 2 years already? Wow. Time flies. And since then, of course, as always, Artomatic is known for, and one of our signatures is that physical space, right? That you all have known to love and have participated in. And so we're working hard, trying to find and nail down a location. And in between that time, we're also making sure that we have a wonderful breadth of knowledge on our Artomatic board. So we have had so many wonderful new board members come aboard within the last couple of years, and it has been fantastic. I have to say, though, that since I have been on the Artomatic board, we've always had, there's always been wonderful people on the board. So it's just, you know, with our board terms, we have had a nice matriculation of people transitioning into other things in the arts, and then we've had new people come aboard. So that's a wonderful thing. As it relates to reaching out to you all as our community, as you all know, you've been hopefully getting those wonderful newsletters that our executive director has been sending out. And also providing the feedback, which is fantastic. And it is much appreciated that folks are taking the time to submit their questions, their concerns, their ideas for Artomatic while we are in between times of finding a location. Aside from that, that pretty much really wraps it up, but we are, a team of people who really collaborate well with each other. So in that spirit of collaboration, if I have missed anything that is important that some of the board members or advisors may think, oh, we should talk about this, please feel free to unmute yourself and let me know. We are, people are saying hello. we could definitely have a conversation around that. It's around 15 of us, so we can have more of a conversation rather than this more like a presentation type thing, I would say. And this is a happy hour, so relax, chill, grab your drink, you know, enjoy. And with that, Tracy, if you don't mind, if you're pouring your drink, go for it. if you don't mind introducing yourself, what we were doing was introducing ourselves, discussing our creative mediums, and if you have participated in our Artomatic or have not, and how long you've been on the board, and any other fun facts that you would like to include.
All right, thanks. Good afternoon, or good evening, everyone. So I'm Tracy. I was formerly an engineer, and I decided to pursue art, being that it's my passion. I've been with Artomatic for a year now, a little over a year. And so as an artist, I work with fiber, embroidery, floss, and beads. I do a little bit of everything, but those are my favorite. I think Artomatic for me has enlightened me so much. So I am so glad to be part of this this organization.
Fantastic. All righty. Okay, we have a couple more folks. It looks like they're joining in. Okay. Shanti. Okay. And so, okay, we what I'm going to do if we don't mind, we have time. The folks who are not on the board or an advisor, do you mind sharing a little bit about you and if you have participated in an Artomatic? That would be fantastic. And I'll call your name. So it looks like Dollar.
Yes, I have participated twice in Artomatic. And I just moved to North Baltimore, but I used to be living in DC. And I'm a docent at the National Art Museum for the last 17 years. I do portraits and landscapes and whatever. I paint furniture. I do art with everything. I owned restaurants in DC for 41 years. So I'm surrounded by people all the time, and there have always been vegetarian Indian restaurants, but mm-hmm. that's what I've been, I painted my tables in the restaurants, and I painted mm-hmm. walls, and I painted all kinds of things. Awesome. I do portraits a lot, and I do, landscapes, and these days I've been doing digital art since I was moving and everything. So I've been doing a lot of digital art.
Well, thank you for that. And welcome to Baltimore. I too recently moved to Baltimore from DC.
Oh, you did? Where did you move to?
I moved to the southwestern part of Baltimore. Mm-hmm.
Where is that? I mean, like near...
Well, we'll talk about that offline. I'm not going to give my...
No, just give me your name. Well, give me your name. I didn't get your name for...
Jamila. Jamila Canty.
Mm-hmm. Jamila Canty. Okay. Yeah. Oh, are you Nigerian?
I am not, no.
Last name is Canty, right? That's mm-hmm. why I asked you.
Yeah.
That's a Nigerian last name, so... Mm-hmm.
So next we have Steve.
Yeah, hi. I have not been on the board. I've volunteered a lot over the years, even helped edit some of the advertising copy. My long ago background was as an editor. I do photography, and I've participated in, I don't know, half a dozen Artomatics. I don't remember when I first started. Couple in Crystal City, one in Bethesda or Rockville someplace. I guess the latest physical one was perhaps in New Carrollton. So I've been doing that. I love the community. I love coming in, helping get the place in order, and interacting with everybody else and with the public. It's a blast.
It is fantastic. Thank you so much, Steve. And we have Lawrence. Lawrence, are you there? Okay, let's go to Ashanti. I love the phonetics.
Hello, how are you guys?
Hi, Ashanti.
Yeah. Hi. Sorry, I'm just getting off of work, so I look a bit rough right now.
You look fantastic.
So yeah, I participated in an Artomatic. I think it was the one in Frederick, Maryland. So it's been a while. I just kind of lost touch or pulse with Artomatic. I don't know if there was like a period of time you guys were going to transition, but somehow I just sort of lost touch with you guys, but yeah, I'm a local artist. I'm actually in Virginia, and a lot of my work is, I don't know how to describe it. I don't quite call it abstract, but it's influenced by like graffiti arts. And so a lot of gouache watercolors and acrylics and some ink, some calligraphy. So it's a mix of different things drawn from different different types of aspirations or inspirations. But yeah.
Mm-hmm. Fantastic. Thank you so much for joining. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, so we have John.
Hi, sorry, my technological skills are not really up to this here. I'm John Noren. In case anyone is interested, I'm expecting to teach part-time at a Chinese school this fall. And I had so much trouble getting my Chinese name into the area where my name shows up that I just have been leaving it there. And I'm always kind of surprised when I see it myself. I do mostly photography. I've been in these paintings you see are my friends have done. They're not mine. I have attended Artomatic as an attendee, not an exhibitor, for a number of years now, pretty much every time I've seen anything come online. So at this point, I'm just really sort of an interested observer, but at some point I'd love to participate as an exhibitor. So I got the message and I thought I'll just check in and say hello to everybody and see what's going on.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for joining. We really appreciate it. Yep. Okay, I think I covered everyone that is actually on the call. So,
Hey, I'll introduce myself. My name is Martha. Maybe you don't see me. I don't know.
I'm sorry about that. Go ahead.
I've been in 3 Artomatics. I'm on the call because I was excited that maybe there was another in-person one coming up and I wanted to learn what was happening with that. I'm a painter, mostly abstract, some mixed media, some oil, some acrylic. And I have a studio and gallery in Reston, Virginia, and I'm in a lot of shows around town. So I'm a full-time artist and I love Artomatic. So happy to see that you're actively pursuing a location and have a working board. That's great. Thank you.
Thank you for joining this evening. Okay. So let's transition before we go into your questions to a little bit about some of the community engagements between the events. Our board, we've been talking a lot about ideas and activities and from your feedback on, you know, what the board could do or what Artomatic could do as an organization to touch base with you. We've implemented a consistent newsletter, which is fantastic, and have a bigger social media presence. So if you've noticed that, congrats to our board and our executive director for that. But I also wanted to see if Catherine or Tracy wanted to touch on any of the community engagement activities or some of the thoughts or conversations surrounding that.
I can go, though I don't want to steal Tracy's thunder. Do you want to go first?
No, go ahead. You probably know more than I do.
I don't know about that. Well, we've been looking for things that we can do in between the big Artomatics that are tied to a space. Looking too at some of the things we did in the 2020 Artomatic, I wasn't on the board then, but some of the things that were done online showing, online lessons. We talked about having an artist spotlight. There were some concerns that we needed to maybe slow that down a little bit before we do it. Other thoughts that people had were very small, like mini Artomatics. Thoughts people had. We had some community outreach where people came to meetings and actually shared these ideas. And I'm kind of hoping that we can do that in a minute or two now, though I want to defer to Jamila to find out when that's appropriate in this meeting. So we thought about spotlights on artists where artists can talk about them, have a quick moment to share their art, what makes them want to create art, what they're working on now. That was one thought. Another was online gallery tours was a second thought we've had, or that other people have actually brought us that thought. I'm being really not glib tonight. I'm really putting my foot in my mouth. A third thought was online demos where someone, and you probably even seen these on YouTube, sometimes established artists. I think Esther K. Smith, a paper artist, did some of these, just sets up a camera and shows how she creates some of her work. So these are thoughts we had or that people brought to us at some outreach meetings. And I'm hoping there'll be a spot in tonight's meeting to ask you, you know, the people who are not on the board and not advisors, if you have any thoughts that you'd like to share, possible things we can do, bearing in mind that sometimes people have great ideas that aren't always feasible because they may be bigger than the person making the suggestion realizes. Boy, that was good.
This would be, you know, this is actually a great transition for that question, because after this, then we can get into the questions that folks have had. So would anyone like to provide feedback as to what Catherine was speaking of as it relates to some engagement initiatives? Did I ask that right, Catherine? You said it so eloquently.
No, actually, I've been putting my foot in my mouth. Yes, would anyone like to share ideas? What do you think would be useful for you and doable? What do you think Artomatic can do for you between big Artomatic events? Something feasible that would be supportive of each of you in your arts practice, something you'd like to see us do.
I'm curious to hear a little bit more about these mini Artomatics that you mentioned. What does that mean and consist of? I have to say, I'm not a big fan of the online stuff, but it works for a lot of people. I don't know. And it works in our camera club, which is fine, but I don't know about the diversity of Artomatic. I just don't know about the online, but I'm curious about the mini Artomatic concept.
Well, these were ideas people brought to us. Oh, George, you should answer this one.
Well, the idea of a mini Artomatic has been discussed, but there are some problems with it, because when you make an open call for people to participate, you don't know who's going to come forward, and trying to put together a small space. You know, right now we're looking at a potential space for the end of August, first of September, in downtown DC, working with the downtown bid. That could be something that hopefully is going to happen. And of course, we did a survey of people's interest, and I think something like 93-94% of the individuals that answered the survey wanted to move forward on an Artomatic. I think that there are some things that we could do that are very simple that would that we had discussed to add to Catherine's comments, and that would be a 1 or 2 minute video that individual artists would do of their studio and send it to us. And we would make that available so that people could see it, almost like a TikTok effort. But there are a lot of things out there, and I think that the board has to decide what efforts that they want to they want to pursue. And Catherine was the big advocate for this session, the idea of cocktail hour. I don't know if she's going to provide wine in the future, but I think that that's something that we can clearly do maybe once a month so that we get a chance to talk to artists that are out there and what they're interested in.
I have a question in regard to doing like the small sort of Artomatics. So part of my question is, is Artomatic connected into like small pockets of art communities throughout the DMV? Like, do you guys have lines into different art communities so that you would be able to do like a small mini Artomatic events? Like, what is the network? Because I guess for me, like, it seems like everything's concentrated in certain areas, but I see there's like people doing arts in different areas. So I don't know like what the draw is like. And I know you guys do different Artomatics at different locations from what I understand, but I'm just saying, like, is it just, you just don't have the momentum to do a mini one because
that's a very good, it's a very good question. And this is something, as George was saying, that the board has, we have discussed this and we're still in discussion about it. But here's one of a few things that we take into consideration as it relates to a mini Artomatic. So as it relates to having an Artomatic event, we call it our signature event, which is that large location, multiple floors, over 700 to 1,000 artists in one location. To have a smaller, venue, so to speak, what does that actually look like? And the way we operate and administer an Artomatic, the amount of the back end, it's still the same amount of, I would say, work, for lack of better terms, to have that mini Artomatic. First, we do have to remain core to our one of our core values, which is it is a non-juried event, right? So the goal for us is to always, if an artist wants to show their work, we have the capacity for them to do that or to display their creativity. That may not be the case if we have a smaller event. As George was alluding to, if you put out a call for artists, we are going to get a substantial amount of people who are interested. And how do we filter that to fit into a smaller event? Is that something that our community would even be open to? Because with that, some artists are going to have to be pared down. Or do we target it by genre of artistry, right? Maybe we can do a mini event for sculptors or a mini event for performers, that type of thing. So these are the conversations that are being had. But to have an event at a smaller location, it does also depend on how small are we talking about with this location? Are we talking about the space in the back of a restaurant? Are we talking about, an art gallery who may be relocating, like those types of things? How do we implement our signature Artomatic so that we're not one jurying artists, right? Mm-hmm. Because that is definitely something that we are totally not here for.
How do you guys filter people now? Because you have the big event. So does everybody get in on the big event? So you guys are able to fit everybody in on a big event. Okay. Yeah. So I guess part of my question is, so maybe it's a matter of doing themes. I don't know. Like, so that's what sort of the Moth does, right? They do storytelling, but they do it by themes. Not everybody can come and tell a story. There's always a theme, and they have like a schedule of this is going to be the theme this month and next month, so people kind of already know what's mm-hmm. going to be the theme. So that's one way of doing it. I don't know but
that your first Artomatic was in Frederick, right?
Yeah.
Is that Frederick was a license program? Some of you are probably familiar with TED Talks, and then there's TEDx. TEDx is a licensed event of TED. And we have taken a page from that experience, and we have begun licensing artists in other communities to create their own Artomatics. So when you participated in Frederick, you participated in a licensed event that was organized and implemented by Arts in Frederick, Maryland.
Okay.
And we've done three there, one in Jefferson County. And Jamila and several other artists that are connected to Baltimore are exploring the idea of doing a licensed event in Baltimore. So that is one of the avenues that we have to look at, if you will, smaller events. But it's also important because it in many respects, we're teaching our fellow artists how to fish for them. Because the concept that many artists have contributed to in Artomatic is an event that is completely open. It is one where everybody contributes time to make it work. It is also a model where you don't need a grant to get started. You can, by putting on the event, you create the money for it. And I think I saw Lawrence ask the question about whether or not we're going to do things in other jurisdictions. Now, over the years, we've done things in Maryland. We've done things in Virginia. We did three in Crystal City. I think we've done two events in Maryland. And so when we look at the map, what one would mostly call the DMV, that would be part of what Artomatic does, that Artomatic runs. But beyond that, so if somebody wanted to do something in Sperryville, Virginia, and get organized, we would talk to those artists and help them create what's needed in order to do an event there. So that's basically one of the ways that we've worked with artists in other locations.
So yeah, that sounds like a path then. To the idea of doing a mini Artomatic.
It's
a matter of passing the knowledge on to whoever's leading it, right? And being a mentor to them or championing them somehow.
Right. And we've got, for instance, two members who are advisors right now are from Frederick. Nico is from Frederick. Bill Watson is from Frederick, Roman is another advisor, is from Virginia. And so one of the things that we've been able to do is to bring on advisors who are from different jurisdictions. And I would say, I'm sure, Dolor, that Jamila is going to give you a call about the Artomatic in Baltimore.
Definitely. But one of the, George, going back to your a statement that you made when you were answering Ashanti, is Ashanti, one of one of the key components of having those mini Artomatics in locations outside of what the Artomatic DC board is doing is that it is initiated by an artist group in that particular location. So that is primarily how that is how that normally happens. So that's that connection, that collaboration of a group of a consortium of artists who are in a particular location and hey, why don't we, you know, look into licensing Artomatic so we can have it here. So that's also, I just wanted to add that too, to just provide a little bit more context with that. Yeah. Okay. That was great. That was great. I really wish I had, so I didn't get a glass of wine. So So we can open it up to the questions from the survey. I think that's going to yield a lot of other fruitful conversations for our board and our advisors as well. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I am opening that up now.
Awesome. In the meantime, does anyone currently on have a question or a comment or a thought? Yeah. Lawrence, I saw your comment in the in the comments section. So Tracy got back to you on that. Okay, no others? Okay, so we can go into the questions.
Okay. I will read out the questions that were asked by you and other folks who maybe didn't attend but asked questions. Here's a big one. I'm not sure we should address this, but I want to read it because it shows such great confidence in Artomatic. How can we make Artomatic a worldwide international art festival? Not sure we can, but thank you for asking that. Unless, would another person like to respond to that?
Yes.
Okay.
But I think that if we have the ability to help artists get organized, for instance, we've done some small collaborations with our sister city, Sunderland, England. One of the things we'd like to see would be the ability for Sunderland to do their own Artomatic. I think that those are some things that are possible through connections with Sister City, plus other connections. Like one of our advisors has been working with printmakers in Medellin, Colombia, and has done several exhibits here in the Washington area as a result of that, including exhibiting them in Artomatic. I think that long-term, these artists in Medellin who've had a chance to work together for about 4 years presents an opportunity to really think about the possibility of a licensed program by doing their own Artomatic in Medellin. So I think it's possible. Certainly artists across the world have the same struggles that artists here have. In many cases, they're different, more difficult. The model that we have where artists do this on their own and make it happen is something that I think we want to share with folks around the world for that matter. Because it's a model that means that artists don't need to be beholden to anyone to execute what they want to do. We've really cut out the middleman, if you will, where artists create an event and we go directly to the public. I think that that's part of the maturation of artists, if you will, taking control.
Yeah, Nancy has her hand up.
Yeah, I was trying to figure out a way how to raise this at previous meetings, but kind of an answer and a question to that is, well, we all kind of know that the Washington Post is not a really arts-oriented newspaper, and it's hard to get coverage for any exhibition, any gallery show, and the people who write don't seem to be really prepared to talk about what they try to talk about. I think we should somehow try to contact a larger print or, you know, online magazine venue. What's wrong with pounding our chests a little bit to tell the world how unique this is? And I'm not sure how you do this, but wouldn't it be fun to read about this in the New Yorker or something, you know? You know, if somebody has connections, I just think it's so unique and fabulous that, it would be an inspiration to people if we could explain it to a wider audience.
Agreed. Yeah. And that is, that's something that we, I'm speaking for the board here with this. That is something that we definitely need to put on our to-do list, because for Artomatic, and we did a little bit of that, but it was still local for the 20th anniversary, right? So a lot of people don't really know that Artomatic is one of the longest running pop-up art exhibits in Washington, D.C., right? So that is like, that is huge in itself. And that's something that we definitely don't beat our chest a lot about. We definitely need to do that. And that is going being jotted down right now for us to actually start really looking in, not only looking into that, but creating action steps to actually implement that. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Great. Thank you.
Well, should we go back to some of the other suggestions that people, or questions that people made?
Mm-hmm.
Question about, this is kind of redundant because we were just talking about this. It's a double question. Can there be more than one event a year? And about mass checks at door, HEPA filtration around the building. So that's kind of a double thing. Can we do it more often? And what could we add to make it more COVID safe?
Okay, I'm going to take the comment of have it multiple times a year. I do not possibly see how that could happen unless we have 50 people on our board and 100 people participating actively in our committees. Okay. And so that actually is a good segue to kind of get an understanding of what does it take to put on an Artomatic, right? And when I say Artomatic, I'm speaking of the signature Artomatics, the ones in Crystal, the ones that were in Crystal City, the one in the Heck Small, you know, those types of Artomatics. And as George has stated, it is ran by the folks who are showing their artwork, right? And who are the artists, right? It is ran by the artists. So first, just a quick rundown of what it takes, right? The location needs to be suitable for an Artomatic, right? It needs to be ADA compliant. We need to make sure that there's no fire hazards there. So there's like that component of making sure that the location, the building, for one, is a suitable building for Artomatic. From there, it's administrative. How do we need to do a registration? Folks need to choose their location. There are artists who are managing that process. And as you all know from participating or attending an Artomatic, you have people who are volunteers who are working the floors, doing their shifts, right? So one of the reasons why we have been able to keep the price for participating in Artomatic so low, I'm looking to see if anybody from the board is longer that was like, but our fee is extremely low for a 6 weeks art exhibit. Okay, so that in itself is pretty phenomenal. It's low, I believe it's lower than $150 for 6 weeks. And if an individual sells their artwork, they get 100% of that profit. And Artomatic as an organization, through the fees, are being able to pay for the location, okay? The locations are not donated to us. They're not free. So we do have to pay for those types of expenses. But aside from that, it's training individuals to assist our guests when they come in and out, making sure that people are not damaging the artwork, removing the artwork during the event, scheduling and coordinating the installation of these Artomatic. And as you all have seen, there are hundreds of artists who participate, right? So you have to coordinate all of that. And then you have to coordinate when you are taking down your artwork. So that's one component, right? But we also have performances. So we have a group of volunteers who are managing, coordinating those performances. You know, should anyone have another wedding at Artomatic, we have volunteers who are doing and managing that aspect. So it is, and when I say volunteers, I am referring to us, the artists who are displaying our artwork. Some have jobs, and other responsibilities as well. So it's making sure that people can, one, hone in on a chunk of time where they can be fully present to provide the services that are needed to run a successful Artomatic. I think that's like three components, but then there's also components of making sure that, you know, the fire dancers outside are, you know, okay. And, you know, I mean, it's Dollar's laughing at me right now, but this is what it takes. It is a well-oiled machine and it's primarily ran and managed by the Artomatic board and volunteers. So to do that twice a year, I don't see it unless we can duplicate ourselves. Technology's been doing some wonderful things, but I doubt that that's really going to happen. But to have a signature event twice a year is I don't foresee that being doable. I just don't see that being doable. If someone else has another thought or would like to add to that or have a comment about that, you know, feel free to unmute, because this is that actually has came up a couple of times. Why not we have a couple of Artomatics, and after board members have went through the first one, they're like, okay, to turn around and do that again. We want to keep our board, right? We want to keep our advisors, and we want to keep them happy and mentally strong, and that it does take a lot out of an individual who is strictly volunteering to do that. And I just can't see asking the board to do that twice in 1 year, not in 1 year. Nancy, you have a...
Yeah, I think from an outward facing standpoint also, if we're getting monetary donations for underwriting, or if we're getting in-kind donations or cooperating with some, you know, vendor or something, I think it's a lot to ask them to give stuff to us more than once a year.
That is actually a very good point that you brought up. We do work with a lot of vendors also during Artomatic who are donating some items that we need and to use to run a successful Artomatic. So yeah, to ask them to do that twice a year also is definitely a lot. Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah. There was a second part of that question.
It was about what we're doing to make it safe during COVID. Like, we haven't really had one since COVID started, but would we be requiring masks? Would we have HEPA filters? Mm-hmm. So this is a nice way to look at, I don't know how to phrase this, one of the reasons we haven't had an Artomatic in person for a few years has been COVID. Another reason is that we don't have an Artomatic every year because it's not always possible to find a building. I am just, the first Artomatic I worked on, I was just in awe of the one time, I forget, we had a committee meeting, but we caught the end of the executive committee meeting of the board. I was just on the performing arts committee. And I knew it must have been a lot of work, but I was watching George. It was the first time I ever saw George. I'm sitting here like jaw dropping at everything that went into this, but it all starts with finding a building that we can use. So in addition to not having a building every year, we haven't been able to do anything because of COVID, had there even been a building available. Now the world's beginning to reemerge a little bit. And this question was, what would we do if we had a building? And what would we do to make it more COVID safe?
One of the things that we talked about this briefly in one of our board meetings was to, one, whichever location that we're having Artomatic is to be mindful and to adhere to the standards that are set by that particular jurisdiction. But we also had conversations about, are we doing timed entries to make sure that it's not too crowded, those types of things, which hasn't been solidified as of yet. But for the individual who asked the questions, that is something that is definitely is on the minds of the board as it relates to, we're in a pandemic, we're slowly getting out of it. How do we still keep everyone safe? You know, we don't want any new variants coming around. So it's just, what would be required to do that? And if making sure that the ventilation is appropriate for the building, we have a whole building like site committee that focuses on those particular things and those particular items for when we do have a building. So that would probably fall within that realm. But overall, as a board, it is definitely something that we would have to discuss a little bit more thorough when we have a location and we have a go. Okay, this is what it is. We need to make sure that we are adhering to the laws for hosting an in-person event.
We had one really nice comment. It wasn't a question, it was just a comment, which was, how can cultural tourism, do you see, help? So I don't think there's anyone here from cultural tourism. It was, how can cultural tourism, do you see, help meet your goals?
I love it. One is sharing the information about Artomatic, right? Making sure, assisting with getting the word out there when we do have Artomatics. And in the past, we've publicized through that organization before. But it's also assisting with maybe calls to artists for possibly committees. I don't know if we've done that before, but you know, I think that would be really beneficial for Artomatic. Are there any donors out there who loves Artomatic, loves the vision, loves the fact that it's a non-juried organization, and would like to partner, donate, to assist us in our goals? Aside from that, those are, I think, the three off the top of my head. Does any other board members have anything? Oh, George, you would be, what would you think, George?
The cultural tourism folks, I know them. The guy was the executive director, Stephen, I can't think of his last name right now. I'm glad they asked that question. We've used them in the past. I mean, they're part of our network that we communicate what we're doing. But I think that it would probably be worthwhile for us to have a conversation with them, to talk about how they might be able to help us, particularly as we're doing these events, that the conversation, for instance, cultural tourism's responsibility is to communicate with potential visitors to Worthington. That's their jurisdiction and goal. And I think that if we look at the meeting that we're having right now, their ability to help us get one set up in Boston or in Albuquerque. I think that there are, if they know that we're interested in doing some of those things, then as things cross their desk, they might very well refer them to it. Now that's just one thing that could happen. The other is we could clearly ask them what they might want to do. Let's say we have an event 6 weeks long. Would they commit to do something every week? Some kind of a large article or information about Artomatic, more than just putting us on a list of other things that are going on. You got to remember that they're just coming out of a pandemic too, because we have lots of visitors to Washington, and that's changing now. And we might very well be a part of what would be useful for them. So I think it's worth a conversation. I made a note to myself to give them a call. When any other board member that's interested can join me. We have maybe a Zoom call or actually sit down and have coffee together. But I think that's a good example of how Artomatic works. Somebody raises a question and we begin to think about how we can work with them and collaborate.
Thank you, George. I see another board member who joined us and would like to, since we have guests on, if Mary Lee would like to introduce herself. Hi.
Hi, everyone. I'm sorry I came in late. I got mixed up with Tuesday, so I took off early from work on Tuesday, so I couldn't again say I have to leave early today. So I'm sorry, but next time I will be on time. My name is Merrily. I'm an artist and I love Automatic, and I'm hoping that in some way I can contribute.
Awesome. And we're glad to have you on board as a board member as well. Yeah. So we could actually, as you all can see, we have very fruitful, very great conversations, but I do want to do a time check because it is 7:37. And we scheduled an hour. If you all don't mind, if we could take one more question, we'll definitely be doing this again.
I have one question. Do we have a space for, because people have been mentioning that there's a fall Automatic coming. Do we have a space for the fall for September?
We do not, we don't have a space confirmed. Okay. We don't have a space confirmed as of yet. George shared in the beginning of the cocktail hour that there's some potentials for the fall, but the board hasn't confirmed it just yet. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, shall we do one more question? The one last question? Let's take one more question though from the survey if we can.
You know, there were no other questions from the survey except for when is the next Artomatic or what else are you doing? There were several people asked that in different ways. Yeah. But I'd also like to tell you that several people said on the survey, not questions, just like let me pull up the exact words because I'm flipping screens here, which you probably can tell that I'm flipping screens here, but I just want to meet and thank the board, or I just want to find out what's new. How's it going? You know, supportive statements like that. Let's see, no questions at this time. I'm just happy to see that Artomatic's still around. I would just like to meet board members. So, you know, positive things. So no actual questions, but I think they were worth mentioning because they show that either people just like Artomatic because they're saying nice things, or they like Artomatic and want to know when the next one is.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I second that. I just want to thank everybody on the board for all of your efforts, and go get them.
Thank you, Steve. Well, I want to thank, on behalf of the board and the advisors, I do want to thank you all for taking the time out. This is our first cocktail hour. Again, thank you, Catherine, for the idea and the rest of the board Tracy, for just implementing this and coordinating this. I have a feeling we're going to start doing this regularly, which is fine, which is fine. It's needed. And also it gives us an opportunity as board members to have one-on-ones with our Artomatic community outside from an event and we're running here and running there, right? So this is the time to get a little bit more understanding of us as individuals, us as an organization that you have participated in, as well as what it takes to run an Artomatic and what's happening in between time. So does anyone have any closing statements? Well, yes.
I want to ask, what are you guys expecting of the advisors? What is the expectations for the advisors?
The advisors of Artomatic are definitely one to advise, and they are also kind of like a great cohort of our organization. So it's getting the word out there to organizations and groups, providing sound expertise in matters that the board may not have the wherewithal to address, and or the contacts to reach out to. So I will say, as an advisor, we have someone on our, as an advisor, who has been around in the art scene for some time, and to be able to, for us as an organization and fellow for advisors to learn under that tutelage is great. I'm speaking of George, but the advisors is primarily to advise the board and to also participate in our meetings. I'm not going to get into the administrative components of that on this particular setting. That's more for a board meeting. But overall, it's primarily to advise the board on particular items, maybe some ideas that the board may be thinking about, or ideas that the board should open up about, so as those types of things as well. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, folks. Well, cheers to you all for a wonderful evening. Thank you all. And it's great to see you all's faces, great to meet our Artomatics. And I look forward to the next cocktail hour.
Thank you for joining.
Bye, everyone. Where's
it going to be? When is the next meeting?
We haven't scheduled it yet, but when we do, we will definitely send out another round, another invite. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Well, the invites always come by email.
Yes.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Always by email. But you on the board, you'll know. You'll know beforehand.
Okay. Because I always check my text, but not my. And I remember I text you so much on Tuesday. I was so nervous.
Yeah. So I'll touch base with you offline about that. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Bye, all.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Night.
Hi.